Okay, everyone, and welcome back to the midweek market wrap-up for, I have to check, the 20th of July, 2022. Again, if you're new here, my name is Michael Noss. I'm a chartered market technician, quantitative trader. What we do every Wednesday is we sit down and just look at the crypto, FX, and equity markets, see what's going on, what's happened so far this week, what we think may happen into the end of the week. And this culminates into a live stream I do every Sunday at 7 Eastern. Link is in the description below. You can come and hit that. You hit the subscribe and the bell and it will let you know. Or you can go to my website and sign up for my email list. I don't sell the emails. All I do is say, hey, this is when I'm going to go live. Or this is a blog post that I think you might like or a video or something like that. So without further ado, let's just get into it and start here with Bitcoin. Little bit of a rally the last few days. We had this kind of bear flag consolidation going on here for a very, very long time. Broke that 2 days ago, and now we're kind of pushing up as well. So we have this anchored VWAP from the last swing low, which is how I draw them in downtrends. I'll do the anchored VWAPs from lows, and from uptrends, I'll do them from highs. And we are running into resistance right now as I took the screenshot. Now, obviously, again, still an overall bear trend. I'm going to be doing a lot of this video. I called myself Captain Buzzkill on Twitter because I just remind everybody. Everyone gets excited and says, oh, is that the bottom? Is now when I should pile in all my money? But we are still in a bear trend, so we have to be careful. Take your shots, take them strategically, take them with a stop loss, but understand that you're still counter trend trading for now anyway. Aussie dollar, and another interesting one. This thing is actually coming up, and this blue area that I have here, this is an interesting area for me anyway, because this was, if you go back on the chart, it was support for a very, very long time, and now we're working our way back up to it, and if that holds as demand now, then you know things could turn lower. So if we get up to that area, I may look to initiate a short position. Into the equity markets, we can see here on the S&P 500, same kind of thing, right? So one thing I will note for people who are Bitcoin maxis is basically, if you look at the correlation between Bitcoin and the NASDAQ over the last months and months and months, it's pretty much one for one. So you can use one as a proxy for another. It doesn't look like one of them is being a hedge against a down market or a hedge against inflation or anything like this. It is simply a leverage tech play. So again, keep that in mind. You can use your cues, I guess, for the cues, and see if Bitcoin kind of makes sense there. XME, big level here. This is our metals and mining ETF. We talked about this, I believe, last week. Talked about it on the live stream. Just a huge area of support in through here. And we had a nice kind of bounce going on right here. Again, a bounce in a pretty substantial downturn, but this one looks a little bit more bullish to me. And same with the next chart here, which is uranium. So as energy becomes more and more a concern, maybe people switched more to nuclear power and that may increase this. I don't trade from a fundamental point of view, but that might be something people look at. But again, just a nice clean level to play off of. You're at 20, you know, if it gets under 17, you're probably wrong. And just the high of this is 30. So it's a big, good risk reward, even if we get up to the highs. And then if we make new highs, then you're just laughing. Some individual names that I'm watching, this one is Teladoc, TDOC, rounded bottom, and then a bit of a flag right here. So this kind of completes our cup and handle pattern. One thing that I really liked about Teladoc was there's about a 23% short float on it, looking over here at my trade ideas. So about a quarter of the entire float is short. So if we get back up into this range right here, maybe we pop up and fill this gap, which would be a pretty decent return. Higher than that, maybe the shorts get nervous. Who knows? Another one here is DDL. This one's a Chinese play, so be a little bit careful, but just getting incredibly, incredibly tight here. It might be hard to see on the actual video, but it's got one of my favorite patterns for candlesticks, which is a double inside day. So we have a big candle here, and then the next day is inside that big candle, and then the third day is also inside this last day. So just means that on this wide area, we're getting tight, and then on the intraday candle, or the daily candles that are very, very close together, they're getting tight. So it means on an intraday basis that there's some sort of a tightening or flagging pattern going on here. So above that on the short-term candle, maybe that triggers this long-term pattern and we get a squeeze in this. But again, warning, this is China, right? Last but not least for the stocks is BF.B. This is a winery company. Showed up in the relative strength scanners that I run with Trade Ideas. Again, link in the description below. This thing is putting in a little bull flag, and it's putting in a bull flag right at this prior area. So if it can get up and above that, maybe this thing keeps going. This is a slower, maybe a safer play than the other two that I mentioned. So as always, link in the description below for my website if you want more content like this. And trade safe out there, guys.